Hey guys, Mike Caudill with Go RVing, and it's Wednesday, which is our favorite day of the week because I get to jump on in front of all of you and share whether it's tips, tricks, hacks, things happening in the industry, all the fun things going on in the wonderful world of RVing. So I did a recent build for you guys on my personal truck, and it was with Front Runner, which is part of Dometic, and we did this entire kind of overlanding thing. Well, as we get ready to head out this summer, behind our Winnebago Forza, we wanted to do a fun video for you guys on towing a dinghy vehicle behind you. So many of you have seen them going down the road. It's usually a Class A or a Class C that has a vehicle that they're towing behind it. And I brought my checklist and notepad, and I want to cover off on all of the things for you to consider as you get ready to tow this summer. And if you haven't done it before, I'm actually going to do the build. So I've done it twice before on other cars, and I'm going to be doing it on my vehicle as well. You've seen Jeeps out on the road. You've seen Broncos out on the road. There are so many different vehicles that you can tow. And you're really not limited as long as the vehicle can be towed and put into a position of neutrality, meaning it can be towed four wheels down with the wheels spinning. So you have to be able to put it in neutral, but it's more than just that. I've seen so many people going down the road without having the brake attachment set up for their tow vehicle. And that is kind of a law, right? Like, you need to be able to tow down the road, and that tow vehicle needs to have brakes on it. So anyway, I digress. I'm gonna cover through a variety of things. We're gonna be setting it up for this vehicle right here, although it really doesn't matter. It's all just gonna be based on that trailer hitch down below and the electrical outlet. Of course, this is our Winnebago Forza with the 340 diesel, so we got plenty enough power to pull. So here's what I wanna roll through for everybody so that as we kind of do this project, you can follow along. And then of course, we're gonna provide you right after this video with the extended version of what the build entails. So before I get into the products on the table, I just wanna talk a little bit about things for you to consider if you are in the market to tow. So it's really important if you are thinking about towing that the number one thing, and I can't stress this, I feel like maybe it shouldn't be Go RVing with the Caudills, maybe it should be Go RVing and Stay Safe with the Caudills, because safety is just always the number one thing I talk about, whether it's cars, whether it's motorcycles. Shoot, in the motorcycle world, I am always talking about safety. And then of course, when it comes to travel trailers and towing, we're always talking about safety. So I wanna start with this. Obviously for a project like this, just like the Front Runner Dometic build, you gotta follow the directions. The directions are always super important. By following the directions, it ensures that you don't make those mistakes that you can't go backwards with. So I wanna talk about that first. So that's the number one first thing on there. Then the other one is just getting into some of the details. So every RV, meaning our Winnebago Forza, has a weight rating. And that weight rating is for its towing capabilities. Now, what I have on this is irrelevant, mainly because I'm pulling with a 340 diesel. I could pull a full-size truck. It has that much capability with a diesel pusher, meaning engine on the rear. If you have a gas puller where the engine is up on front, then it's gonna be a little bit different, right? So you're gonna have to strategically look at the weight rating, the axle rating, and you have to pay attention to a little bit more. But regardless of what it is you're gonna be towing with, check. And use the manufacturer's specifications for that weight rating. I just wanna put this out that weight ratings, they are not a suggestion. 1 pound over can be dangerous. And I will share a story. I think I did it on the Go RVing with the Caudills page about the very first travel trailer that we bought. I was a novice. I didn't know. I was young. I didn't really think about it, and ended up pulling a 34-foot travel trailer with a Chevy Tahoe, 5.3-liter engine, super small, wasn't meant for that, and it was a struggle to get it home. Now we did it, and I immediately learned my lesson that you don't want to go above those weight ratings. In regards to some of the pros, I just wanted to point this out. So when we did our 27-day trip last year, we were towing a vehicle. What's great about towing a vehicle is we all get to ride in the motorhome together. And if we decide we want to pull off mid-route, right? So we're headed from here, and everybody knows we're going to the Myrtle Beach Travel Park in June. Come by, happy hour, it'll be fun. We'll make sure everybody knows we're there. But if you're en route to the Myrtle Beach Travel Park and you just happen to be going through Gatlinburg, Tennessee, and you're like, you know what, I want to go to Dollywood for a day or whatever it may be, you can just pull off to a truck stop, unhitch your vehicle, and drive. You don't have to worry about taking your RV in. And we've done that before. It's so fun. And it just allows you to unhitch and get out there and do fun stuff and rehitch back up. Or when you get to your campground, the best part about getting to your campground is you unhitch. Hey, can you run to the grocery store? We don't have to worry about taking, you know, 40 foot of a motorhome to the grocery. We just take the vehicle that we're towing. One more pro, by the way, not renting a car. All right, so we're gonna roll through a few things that I want you to remember. If you are gonna tow something behind your vehicle, or if you are going to tow a travel trailer, the concept is the same. Go to an open parking lot on a Saturday or Sunday. I recommend a mall parking lot and practice. Get cones out. Learn how to back your travel trailer up between cones. Huge important point to stop and just point this out. When you are towing a vehicle behind a motorhome, you cannot back up. There is no way to do it. It is dangerous. You can't do it. Don't try it. The way the tow system is set up is not for backing up, is only for pulling forward. So if you try and back up, you will break something. So I just want to make sure that disclaimer is in there. Do not back up when towing a vehicle that is four-wheel down, because remember, your tires in front, your steering wheel, they're loose. They are loose, which means when you go back, that car can go either direction. With that said, it's very easy once you get all of the foundational elements down. So you can choose a trailer, a tow dolly, a tow bar. There's multiple things that you can use to tow behind your vehicle. In our case, and there's so many to choose from, we opted to go with Blue Ox. I've used it before, and I'm just more comfortable with it because I've been using it for a long time. So this is all Blue Ox stuff here, and we'll roll through what you're looking at in a minute. Make sure to connect the lights. So we were talking a minute ago, I've seen so many people going down the road that haven't used. This electrical is here for a reason. You get to plug into this electrical using this cable right here, and that then activates the electrical brakes on your vehicle. But there's a wiring process which we will go through. It activates blinkers, brake lights, all of the things that you want, even your hazards. When you are loading your car, always put your parking brake on because you will put the vehicle into neutral. So if you're putting the vehicle into neutral, you got to put the parking brake on because the minute you put it into neutral, the car's going to roll away. Well, we don't want that. So you'll want to get it up close, and we'll do a different video on actually how to connect. Every time you tow, make sure you check the hitch and make sure that everything is working properly. We use walkie-talkies. So my wife will get out and she will do the full safety inspection, or I will get out and I will do the full safety inspection. And that simply means that we're ready to roll. And we have made mistakes in the past. So the key is not to make those mistakes by using a checklist. All right, and then I want to kind of give you this one right here. While driving your RV and towing, always remember there is something behind you. When you're towing a car behind you and you're in something that's of large stature, you won't feel it behind you. So you just need to make that mental note that, yeah, I need to slow down, go the speed limit, and if I am exiting the freeway, methodically plan out, I'm going to exit this freeway well in advance so that when you do, it's a nice, easy coast off, and you're not trying to jam yourself between other vehicles, which leads me to merging with traffic. When you're merging with traffic, don't forget you have a car behind you. There are a ton of companies, and we mentioned them a minute ago, but I'm gonna throw a couple others out just so that we get the diversity out there. We are using our setup with Blue Ox. There's Reese Anderson hitches, there's B&W Custom Trailer hitches, there's Kurt Group, Easy Lift by Camco, Pull-Right Towing Systems, Trailer Valet. There's so many different options for you to use or think about. Always do your setup the night before. I set up all this up last night. I've got all my tools over here. Everything is ready to go. And then I've gone through all my boxes to make sure that I have everything. And of course, there's nothing worse than setting stuff up and forgetting things. So we have checked our tools twice. With a full length video, I'm gonna walk you through what we're gonna use for the build here in a second. But that full length video is gonna have all the fun stuff of what we do to get this vehicle ready to go. So before we head out, hold on, I wanna give you just a quick overview so you know. These are the actual base plates that are gonna be mounted to the front of the vehicle. On the front of your chassis, you're gonna take these chains right here. You're gonna take this and you're gonna wrap it around your front axle, and then you're gonna actually connect it to your base plate. Wiring, electrical that connects from the RV to the actual tow vehicle itself. More electrical. This is your emergency release, your brake release. So if something were to happen while you were towing, the brakes will actually turn on your tow vehicle and actually stop the vehicle for you. And then last but not least, and I am really excited about this, this is the Blue Ox Patriot 3, and this is their brake booster. So this goes inside the Bronco, and as I hit the brakes on the Winnebago Forza, it will engage these brakes on the Bronco. So the tow vehicle will actually stop in unison with the RV itself. So there you go, everyone. I hope you enjoyed tonight's quick video. Quick, long, yeah, it was long-winded tonight. But there's a lot of really good information in here that I want everyone to just kind of think about as you get ready to do your summer adventures and think about towing a vehicle behind you. So, have a great night, everyone. Appreciate you taking a few minutes to watch this video.